Hello, I am Gena Bazarko. I live in Ukraine. Now I am making a set of tools for repairing machine tools in my workshop. First, I restored the old surface plate. I leveled its plane with precision accuracy. I won't tell about it. I will try to tell you about my hobby in English, as far as I can. Sorry for my bad English. I hope you can understand me. Please advise if I am using names of device and techniques incorrectly. I would be grateful if someone could help me edit the text.
First, I need a good surface plate. I consider the surface plate the main item in the workshop. I bought an old cast iron surface plate inexpensively. I will check the condition of its surface. Then I will level it according to my technology. It will be great. Scale division 1 micron. First, I made C straight edge. Videos about these homemade straight edges should be made and published separately. I use a precision bevel level to check for twist. For this work you need an indicator device with a sensitivity of 1 micron. The straight edge is very even. The price of the instrument scale is 1 micron. I use an industrially manufactured straight edge. It meets the established requirements. It has an error of 8 microns. But I need a perfectly even one, and I level it additionally, relying on the straight edge already made. Now, after additional alignment, this straight edge gives an error of no more than 2/10 of a micron. With a straight edge and Johansen tiles in 1 micron increments, I can scan the surface of the slab. Surface scanned. Plane error now 11 microns. Here is a model of the surface of the slab with a relief magnification of 5000 times. I also additionally made two such straight edge. They will be installed on the sides of the slab as guides for technologically simple scanning of its surface. It took 6 straight edge to complete the job. On the sides of the plate, there are two basic straight edges. They are installed for convenient and fast scanning of the slab surface. I will show you how I glued them with high precision in their position. In leveling this slab, the scanning had to be done 17 times. The straight edge is mounted on side rails, resting on two measuring blocks of the same height. Scanning is performed by measuring the gap between the straight edge and the slab using a gauge blocks. Illustration for clarity. Illustration for simplicity with a minimum number of topography measurement points. I select suitable calibration blocks according to the size of the gap. I move the straight edge according to the measurement scheme. As a result, I get a surface scan. The surface of the surface plate has deviation from the ideal plane. This is how this method works. I make places for gluing the side straight edge. Gap for glue. The straight edge must be glued absolutely precisely. I made illustrations. After looking at them, you can understand what technology is used for precise gluing of side straight edges. First, the surface of the slab is scanned at four corners. An appropriate set of gauge blocks is selected for each corner of the slab. Two straight edges are installed on the created supports at the corners. Their working edges are in the same plane. Using gauge blocks of the same size, the second two straight edges are placed on the first two straight edges. The bottom straight edges are then glued to the slab. The straight edges are now attached to the surface plate in the correct way. How it was done. Slot for glue. I pour glue into the prepared places. After the glue has hardened, I disassemble the fixing structure. I check if the straight edge are exactly located. On the guides, at the corners of the surface plate, I place four identical gauge blocks and make diagonal measurements. If the reeds are identical, then the guides are glued exactly. Now I am scanning the surface plate. After scanning, I mark high areas. I sand the high areas. I control it with a repeater meter. For further alignment, I use lapping. First, a medium-sized soft abrasive. To perform grinding, an iron parallel pipet with a prepared flat side is prepared. Doing this work, I take into account the expansion of the metal from its heating. second lapping using a chromium oxide abrasive. Homemade repeatometer. The surface plate is now very accurate. Error within 1 micron. In the next videos, I will check this surface plate with other devices. One division of the scale is 1/10 of a micron. I am glad to meet you. Thank you for your attention. Goodbye.